the story of you becoming Feifei, I just feel like was fate. It's so magical, that idea of you singing Rocket to the Moon and then getting cast. So can you share a little bit of that story?
That was a really nerve-wracking day for me. I was brought in to do some of the demo record, the scratch recording for the movie. They were still storyboarding, but they wanted to just have some records. So we did the whole movie on that day. And I remember we were running like behind in the studio, and my song was scheduled for last. So I knew I had to nail it because we were out of time. And I was so nervous. I got into the studio and everyone was, you know, like on the edge of their seats with their phones out. And I couldn't handle it. So I just closed my eyes and I felt like I got to lock in with our pianist and really find Feifei, because that song, like, if you sing that song, you know who Feifei is. And that is when I really connected with the character. And then they really loved it. And I just, it was crazy. I mean, I felt so proud, but also a little like overwhelmed. It felt really surreal that they loved it so much.
And then getting to, you know, share this story on screen, you know, it's Chinese folklore, but it's universal. For you, was it something, did you know about the moon goddess growing up? Did you celebrate the autumn festival? Or by becoming part of this project, you have a new appreciation for it?
Both, you know, so I grew up and my parents put me in Chinese school when I was young. So I learned about Chang'e a long time ago. And we would celebrate different Chinese holidays and Filipino holidays. And I was lucky enough to go see lots of dragon dancing and lion dancing and lantern festivals. But, you know, I think actually really, I mean, telling this story and being able to present a new version of Chang'e, or the rest of the story, maybe try and propose the rest of the story, is really special. I feel like it feels like I've connected with the culture in a new way, because I actually feel like I'm adding to it, which is a strange feeling, right? I don't know. It's a huge honor and a privilege to have worked with all these amazing Asian artists to create a new Chinese story. So it's very exciting.
I feel like it's at such the perfect timing. Who would have thought that it would come out at a time where we're all being forced to embrace change and kind of adapt as we go, which I feel like is a huge theme within the film, and loss and the unexpected. So maybe touch a little bit on those.
When we first meet Feifei, we know that she's passionate about science, really loves her family, and is determined to the ends of the earth to protect the people that she loves. But, you know, she's holding on to something in a way that isn't actually letting her move on. So it really becomes this beautiful journey for both Chang'e and Feifei to heal with each other, to challenge each other and then lift each other up, which the whole world deserves right now. I mean, we're all experiencing loss in some way, and the only way that we can get through it is by finding people to love and finding people to take care of and find joy again, you know? So I think it's the perfect moment, actually. I mean, it's important for the world to experience these characters and feel connection again, you know?
Obviously, you're in the creative arts, so that's a passion of yours. But your character, you know, she can engineer a rocket. She understands how the train works. She loves science. Was that something that you could connect to? Or again, did that kind of flourish because of the project?
Well, actually, I really have always loved science. And space exploration in particular. So it's really cool. My partner is studying to become an astronaut right now. So like, we're obsessed with space. And I always joke now that I made it to the moon before him. So, in so many ways, this character felt so fulfilling. And it just felt like being able to share my joy for science, you know, just through Feifei's voice, but sharing my own joy. And I hope that it sparks some curiosity in other people, especially young girls. You know, we need more young girls in STEM. So I am really proud of that.
Cathy, you are such a delight. Thank you so much for taking the time. And I cannot wait for families to see this film.
Me too. Thank you.